Okay. So what I came up with, as I said, was an application that allows you to create complete snapshots of your system's configurations. So the snapshots will really contain all of your metadata, all the objects with the fields, validation rules, record types, list views, but also all the other stuff like workflow rules, alerts, classes, pages, triggers, reports, report types, roles, profiles, everything the metadata provides us with. And then you can compare these to each other in a hierarchical tree-like structure. The system will do this for you automatically. And you can then choose all the metadata you need for your project out of this tree view and simply deploy it directly from there. And simply, it's one click. To give you an idea what this tree-like structure looks like, it's basically a tree grid. I've prepared this small sample for you. You can see here it's only included one object, the account object, with four sample fields. It's 1 to 4. And it's already expanded. If you use the tool, you have to expand the tree more and more. On the first look, you would see that there are differences in the objects somewhere. So at least one object is different than the two systems. You don't know yet where, you have to expand the tree more and more, and then you will see that the changes are in the count object, specifically in the fields 2, 3, and 4. You can also see that for field 1, everything is all right, so there are no differences at all. It's completely the same in the two systems. You can then go on and have a look at if the system, if the components are even available in the two systems. So for example, for the field 3, you can see that in the developer sandbox, this field isn't there, but in the QA sandbox, it's available. So somebody put it there before creating it in the developer sandbox. The opposite is the case for field 2. For field 4, you can see it's actually available in both of the systems, but there are differences somewhere. So you have then to go on, expand the tree more and more, and you will then see that perhaps the picklist value was added or updated, the description or label has changed, or maybe it's just required in one system, but not in the other. I'll show you that in more depth in the live demo later on. Another approach of identifying the differences, instead of comparing two snapshots from two different systems, is to compare two snapshots from the same system, just for different times. So this way, you would typically generate the first snapshot before you start with the project, and then go on and grab more and more snapshots by different milestones in your project. And the system will then automatically compare the snapshots, and you will be able to see to exactly identify the components your development team or anybody has changed, and what exactly these changes were. So you can have a really nice overview of what changed in the meantime. And of course, the system will compare these snapshots to each other. You can then, from this tree, from this comparison, again, select all the components you want in a hierarchical way and deploy them to the target system. Another nice feature here is you have also the ability to kind of tag your project components. So the way I do this is I simply write the project name in the description field of my components. So really in the description field of the objects I add, of the fields, the validation rules, workflows. I think this description field, all of you should know this, is available in almost every component. For those components like classes, triggers, pages, components, where we have the source code, we simply can write the project name as a comment in the header of the file or anywhere else. And then later on in the tool, in this tree grid, in our comparison, we have the ability to use a full text search to search for those project names. And the system will then automatically show you all the components you or your developers, your administrators, whoever, have added to your system and provided these components with this tag name. And you can then again simply deploy it. So this is really nice if using Sandbox for different projects, but don't want to deploy all the changes, of course, but want to identify only the changes for one project. Or, I don't know, you have an administrator who's trying out something in your Sandbox and you don't want to deploy the changes of this administrator. Just those that affect your project, really. Other big pain point for me is always the documentation of a Salesforce system, and Salesforce is kind of self-documenting. You have this description fields in place almost in every component, as you probably know, but you have to look in the system itself to get this information. And I thought it would be a waste if I already got all this metadata in my snapshot not to use it to create a documentation document out of this. And this is why I included some kind of a templating system. So you can create some kind of template. It's, I think, similar to Conga Mail Merge template, for example. I think most of you are perhaps familiar with this one. And in this template, you can then access the complete metadata hierarchy. So again, all the objects with fields, list views, validation rules, and also your profiles, roles, classes, reports, whatever the metadata API provides us with. And you can then select all the stuff you want to include in this tree we saw earlier, and the system will automatically, with one button click, generate you a configuration handbook out of this information. Can really be from, I don't know, two sites, two pages, up to a few thousand. It's really, really comfortable. I think that was enough to give you an idea of the system. I'll now go on with the live demo. I have to switch the monitor, one moment. So this is the start page of the application, if you can see it. As you can see, it's running in the browser on the Heroku platform provided by Salesforce. And the first thing you can see here on the left side is the list of all the Salesforce systems you have added here. Of course, you can add new ones if you want to, or also delete old ones. I have prepared two systems for this demo. It's a developer. Oh, let me. Okay, I think it's okay. It's a developer sandbox and QA sandbox in this case. If I now select the developer sandbox, you will be able to see all the snapshots you generated for the system on the right side. Of course, you can also generate new snapshots. If you click on this button, you have to enter your credentials, and then the system will create or will request the complete metadata set, everything that you can get out of the API from Salesforce, and pass it and write it in a hierarchical tree structure into a local database, which enables the system later on to compare these two systems, or these two snapshots in this case, to each other. I have created a few snapshots. The first one is basically a snapshot of a completely blank developer org. In the second snapshot, I have modified the system, included a few components for two projects, in this case, two really simple products we have created. And I'll show you now the differences that we can see that were added in the meantime. So I simply click on Show Differences. What you can see now is, in the top left corner, is the consistency of the two snapshots. In this case, it's 96%. In the middle, you have the full text search function. I'll show it to you later. And on the right, we have the deployment functions, which I'll also show to you later. So I'll do a sample deployment later on. The heart of the application is this tree grid. It's basically the same as I've shown to you earlier. And what we can see now on the first look is that there were made changes to classes. So in the first snapshot, there weren't any classes. I'm not sure, is it big enough? Can all of you see it? Okay. In the first snapshot, there weren't any classes in place. In the second, there were classes added. So we can simply extend the tree here and then have a look at the classes that were added. In this case, it's this auto follow class. It's has class for our auto follow product. So it's basically used to automatically start following on a record criteria based for different users. And the corresponding test class for this function. The second project is the record aggregator, which is basically a kind of roll-up summary function for standard lookup fields. I will now focus on the autofollow function in this case. Just included two projects to show you later on how we can search for one project and just deploy these components according to this project. Of course, if we extend this, we can also have a look at the code here. We can also do diff on the code. I'll show that to you in the next snapshot. We have also a few changes in the objects, as we can see here. I'll show that to you. We have custom setting object aggregate settings, which we use for our record aggregator. As I said, it's configurable. And we have two objects for the autofollow product. Let's just have a look at the autofollow settings. If we expand it, we can see the complete configuration for this object, as you can see here. So the description, the label, everything, the complete configuration of this object, and in a hierarchical way, as I promised, also the fields, the list views. If there were record types, validation rules, you would also be able to see them here. Let's have a look at the field. In this case, we have the criteria field, which is used to start the following based on this criteria. For our product, we have an active flag, the object name for which this should be triggered, and we have a type field. I want to have a deeper look into this. It's a picklist field. I can also have a look at the picklist values here, as you can see, so you just can expand it. In this case, we only have one value at the moment. It's the follow value. So we can just use this product, this function right now, to start following records. I'm just showing that to you because in the next snapshot or next milestone, in this case, we'll expand this or extend this functionality to also handle unfollowing, which is what I want to show you now. So I'll switch to the next snapshot. So I'll now compare the second and the third snapshot. As you can see, now we have changes identified in the classes and in the objects. If we have a look in our objects now, we can directly see the autofollow settings. It's available in both of the systems, so the object is already there in our test and in our QA system. But there are changes, as we can see, and we'll expand it. We can then see the changes are just in some fields. In this case, just in the type field. And we can directly see just the picklist value that was added in this case. So it's our unfollow value, as I promised. It wasn't available here. It was added in the meantime. And of course, we also had to update our programming, so our class in this case. Let's have a look at the code itself. It's this autofollow class in this case. If we scroll down, we can directly see there was a line added in this case. It was added by me, as you can see, and it says edit support for unfollowing. And if we scroll down more, we can directly see which code exactly was edited and added. So we can see in this line here, so line 90, there was a criteria added to this if clause to handle this unfollowing in this case. And you can see here this green block, simply the block that was added to handle this new function. Of course, we also had to update our test class in this case. So let's have a quick look into this one to cover our new functionalities. And you can also see directly at one look which code was added to this test class. I also did a few changes to the record aggregator functionality, but I want to focus on the auto following now. I would like to show you the deployment function now, because that were only a few changes, and to make things a little bit interesting, I have created one more snapshot where I added a few more components like email templates, reports, stuff like this. So I'll select the last developer sandbox snapshot and one snapshot of our QA system. where we want to deploy our changes to. Again, I click on show differences, and now we can see there's yes, really much red in our tree now because I added that much components. I will now search for our project name. In this case, I simply tagged it with project autofollow. Just search for it, and the system will then immediately highlight all of the places in our tree where the components for our projects are located. So in this case, I added an application called autofollow. We want to deploy this, so we simply check it here. Of course, we will find our two classes, so the autofollow and autofollow test. We can have a look at the code again, and you will see project autofollow is now highlighted because I simply wrote it in my class header. This is why it's found. I also added an email template located in a new folder, autofollow templates. I just select the complete folder. So this deployment function works also in a hierarchical way. So if you select a folder, everything beneath it will be also deployed. Same for the object in this case. So if I check these two objects, then all fields, all list views, validation rules, record types, everything beneath this will be deployed unless you uncheck it. This is also possible, so you're completely flexible. You can exclude fields, validation rules, record types, whatever you want from the deployment. I also added a report, which is located also in a new report folder. I want to deploy the complete folder, which is using a custom report type. Also want to deploy this one, of course. And I also included a custom tab, which is used by our application. Of course, we also want to deploy this. After that, we simply have to choose the direction of the deployment. In this case, we want to deploy from the developer sandbox to the QA sandbox. That's all we have to do. If we want to deploy to some other target, we can do this here. So we have the list of our complete Salesforce systems, which you can choose from. This can be used, for example, if you're comparing two snapshots of one system and then want to deploy to another target system. But in this case, we simply want to deploy from our developer sandbox to our QA sandbox. So we just have to click on deploy. The system will then create your package in the background. As you can see, the status is right now enqueued for package creation. It will change soon, I hope so, to package created. It is done now. You have to enter your password then. And of course, the security token. There it is. I hope so. What you can do, if you want to be absolutely sure, you can download the package which was created before deploying it, just if you want to have a look at the package itself, or you simply click on Start Deployment. System will then redirect you to this new status page for the deployments. As you can see, the first line is our deployment now. It's deploying right now, and we should soon see the status. So there were no errors till now. Now it's already completed, so 21 of 21 components were deployed. We can also have a look at the details down here. And of course, of the details of the components that were deployed. In this case, we have only successes. So we can have a look at the components that were deployed, actually. If there were any errors, you would also be able to see them here. Same for the test results. In this case, no tests were run, so we'll not see anyone. But if there were tests, you would see them here. So that was it with the deployment. We actually deployed our project. Thank you very much. But there's one more function I want to show you. If you only select one snapshot out of our list, you can click on this Generate Handbook button, and you will be presented with a similar tree structure to the one before. You can now simply select all the data you want to include in your handbook. In this case, I'll just show you a quick example. So I'll choose the autofollow settings or the autofollow users we've used earlier, the two objects. And one workflow I've created for this demo in the autofollow settings. But as I said, you are really completely flexible. You can include all of this data. You can create a new template, upload it here if you want to, or simply choose an existing one. Then just click on Generate Handbook, and the system will generate it for you and download it to your system. Let's have a look at it. As you can see, you now can see a list of the objects. In this case, the first object is the autofollow settings. Beneath here, you can see the description, so also our project tag, and of course, further description, which is really describing this object. We have a table in which we loop over all the fields. So in this case, you can see the name, the type, the description itself, in an head text formula. In case it's a pick list value, you are also able to see the values here. In this case, you can see it's the follow and unfollow value of our type pick list field we've seen earlier. So we are really very flexible here. In this case, we really looped over all the objects in this paragraph. Then we looped in the table over all the fields, and inside of the table we again looped over all these pick list values, so you can do it with every component you wish. We also can see the record types down here. In this case we don't have any record types, so we'll not see it. One validation rule I included, so you can see the name, description, formula, error message. And down below our next object, so the autofollow user, same. Place for this, and the one workflow we have included with our name, the description, the trigger type, if it's active, the criteria, and actually the action. Of course, you can also then include the action and provide details for this action, or as I said, include the profiles, roles, also the classes if you want with the code, whatever you wish to. If you're interested in it, I'll show you the template itself, how it actually looks. It looks very similar, of course, because the complete structure is taken over in the actual document later on. As you can see here, we simply use such expressions for looping, in this case, over the objects. I'm not sure if it's big enough that you can see something. So this all from this line to this end line here will be repeated for each object. Then we've included this table, and in this table, again, we loop over all the fields, so everything in this block will be repeated for each field. We can then access all the different data we want to access, in this case, the full name, the type, the description, so we are completely flexible here. And in our values column, we also loop over all the picklist values. So we can do it really on every level, as deep as we wish. You can include your own design, your logos, whatever you want to. Let me switch back a moment. So that was basically it. That was a live demo. Of course, there are also a few other functions I like to include in the future. For example, continuous integration functions. So you will be able to visually build some kind of business flow, your system landscape, and define the flows from your developer systems in the staging era, stuff like this. Then define the change sets, as we have seen earlier, which should be deployed, or if it should be deployed based on a project name, so they will be flexible. I want to integrate a Git integration also, and what I think is very nice, Jira integration, so that developers will be able to map change sets to existing issues in Jira. The project manager can then just approve these new functionalities or issues, whatever, out of Jira, and they will then automatically be deployed in the system or manually deployed by a deployment manager, whatever. If you want to get more information, I've set up a first small page, Codido.net. Codido is the name I chose for the project for compare deploy document. Just have a look at it. You can leave me a comment if you want to. You can write me an email, ask questions. I'll answer all of them, I promise. And you can also register for a trial account, which is not available right now, but I'm working on it, and it will be available soon. And then you can have a look at the application for yourself and test it. That was it. Thank you very much for your attention.
Hello. Excellent. Thank you, Oliver.
Thanks very much.
If you have any question for Oliver, please raise your hand.
For the project tagging, you said it it fills in the descriptions of attributes, et cetera, et cetera.
Oh, right? So I can't.
There we go. The project tagging, you said it fills in the descriptions of attributes, et cetera, correct?
Yes. Basically, it's.
Does it overwrite? Sorry, does it completely overwrite the description or append it each time?
No. You are just able to provide. This project name wherever you want in Salesforce. It's basically a complete full text search, so you just can include this tag name somewhere in your description field, or maybe if you want to in the label, or as I said, in the class as a comment, and the system will search everywhere. So you can also use this full text search, for example, to search for all places in the system where some object or field is used. So if you search for field name, you will find all the classes, all the pages, the workflows, the validation rules everywhere where it's used in the system. So it's completely flexible. It was just an example. This is how I use it. I simply add it to the description. You're welcome.
Next question.
Hi. As far as the profiles go, are you able to just select the profiles for the different objects that you or fields that you've created and automatically have them included in the build file for
yes.
the deployment? So any of the changes will automatically come over with the profiles, so that
if you choose the profile, yes, then they will be deployed. Yes, you can also deploy the changes on their own. So only the profile changes without the objects. If the object's already in place in the and the target system, then you would be able to deploy just the profile settings on its own.
Okay, and it would just be the changes for the items that you selected that
yes.
would go along with the profile, just like a regular build XML, but I don't need to bang my head against the wall?
Yes, at the moment it's not possible to automatically include the profile settings for the components you chose. You have to do it manually, but it will be included in the future, so it's also a point on the roadmap, so just a button which allows you to include all the profile settings based on the decisions you already made on the objects and classes and whatever, yes.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
What is the cost of this app?
So I don't know yet. It's still some kind of development, as I said. I'll provide a trial account in the near future. If you're interested in it, just register on codido.net. And I'm not sure what it will cost. I have to rethink this. I put all my energy in developing this. And oh,
next question.
In the front here. Thanks.
Sorry, maybe you mentioned it, but you said available shortly. What's your timetable for available the demo version to be available shortly?
For the demo version, I think it would be 1 to 2 months. Yes. I try to do it as fast as possible. There are still a few points I have to work over to make it available for you. As it's really processing intensive, so every time you generate a snapshot or you compare something or you generate a handbook, it will be done in a Heroku worker process in the background. So this is really cost intensive, and I have to modify this a little bit to make sure I can afford this.
We have time for one more question.
For the deployment, do you support the delete?
I'm sorry?
For the deployment part, do you support like a delete, drop a field, drop an object? Delete an object from your target org?
I still don't understand your question. I'm sorry.
For the deployment part, do you support to delete, like if you drop the object from your development org, do you support to delete that out of your...
You mean if I support to delete it?
Yes.
So a destructive change set in this case. No, not for now, but it's on the roadmap. I will include it. I promise.
That's great. One more question before we let you...
So do you have any roadmap for Perforce integration? I saw Git integration.
No, not right now. It's just in my head. But I'll let it out.
Sure. All right. Thank you again, everyone. Thank you, Oliver.
Thank you very much.